battling for third place, potentially a spot in finals as the only consistent member. Now we've got just enough time to get that story out as the Mad Lions are making their first play. The rookies, the young guys, jumping up onto Wonder, and this will be first blood. And it actually fits our story beautifully.
Yes,
Shadow
sir,
gets
it does.
An advantage.
He plays being one of the big standout players right next to Humanoid. Now he looks for another play.
Yeah, absolutely the case. Oh, I
lost
my Phoenix.
Man.
Though, nicely done. And of course, that's a reply. Humanoid, if this game goes an even footing into the mid game, you've already talked about how strong Cho'Gath can be.
Yeah, and actually, Shadow's down here towards the bottom side. They're just going to look for the 2v2 as Kaiser flashes in.
Well, there's the flash bonk onto Caps's head. Kaiser gets the root. Not enough for the kill just yet. Flash still available to Ocean as well. Infernal will be next. We've got either a Mountain or a Cloud Rift coming our way. Cloud Rift, again, could be very valuable for both squads as Wonder and Arome trading back and forth. Feast is available for
yes,
Wonder.
Sir. And bye-bye. That's he just ate him.
Time.
Wonder
I was just gonna
just
say it.
Ate the man up there in the top lane. It's hilarious too because I wanted to bring up this matchup, but there was too many other things happening on the map.
I tried to set you up.
I know. This isn't your run of the mill tank top lane Cho'Gath. This is gonna be the AP Cho'Gath, but we don't stop the action. There's teleports bot lane. Kaiser's looking for a move.
Okay, Nature's Grasp is available for Arome. It's going to have to be a tower dive, but that flash, that was not...
To look for a play now mid-side, as here we go, personal 1v3.
Very nice petrifying gaze. We'll stop Humanoid, but will not stop the support. Shadow and Arome rock up, and Shadow gets his...
So Humanoid was there before Shadow and Kaiser. Arome's like, hey, let's go for the dive. No one else wanted it, but Shadow finds the insect kick, and now Kaiser's here to finish off Perks.
No petrifying gaze available, and Perks will go down. It wasn't the target they were setting up for.
Pick up the objectives. When G2 start losing, they just start to give you a lot and say, we will trade on the opposite side of the map.
All the plates. Arome's going to be able to arrive in time to defend the top lane tower. Is threatening. And
wait a second.
He's going to look for the chase while that's going on. Second dragon is picked up. This will get the TP, but now will it cost Arome his life?
Yes, it will.
And Frozen Hose.
That's Glacial Augment Cho'Gath.
Oh, my word. The feast will come up in just a moment or two. Arome's going to step forward. Sap magic by sometime. Rupture and feast. Absolutely not worth, my friend. And now Humanoid's in trouble. Yankos continues to chase him down.
On any target instantly. Now, Wonder doesn't have Feast, so the solo kill isn't going to be there. But Caps and Yankos are here, and so is Perks.
Yeah, they absolutely are. Kaiser's now going to get cut down in the river. I'm looking up towards Kazi. He's going to get caught by the Rupture. I think he was caught by the Feral Scream as well. Summon a heal comes out. Defensive flash from Wonder. That's a double kill. Like the rest of the squad has done a lot, as Humanoid will get some damage.
Whoa.
Goes in with a supreme display of talent. Not enough to kill Caps, but will there be enough from the rest of the squad? Kaiser's locked down from the Yumi ultimate, and Yankos will throw the Pillar of Ice. Flash is still available for the Nautilus, and he gets out of the grounding. Man. I always call it the Frozen Hose because I can't remember the actual name. I think it's like GLP-600 or something like that. But nevertheless, let's jump into the fight. True Shot Barrage comes out. Not going to be able to find the kill just yet. Already, Perks is down. It's fourth of the game. Mad Lions are winning the team fight. They have been able to dominate this one. That's one, two, three kills eventually. And it's Shadow that is picking up a lot. 4-1-3. They're 5v5. Their macro play is strong. Individual mistakes across games 1 and 2 have hurt them, no doubt about it. Now they've got themselves in a lead. They've got themselves a potential here. And unfortunately, again, Kaiser just out of position. He gets chomped down. All of the CC from Cho'Gath just allows them to chase, grounding on Arome. The ultimate did nothing from Maokai. The Rupture prevents Shadow escaping, and G2 Esports are chasing for more. Caster Curse strikes the most opportune moment as the exhaust comes down onto Humoroi. He's trying to do something. My word, he does a lot of damage, but he just doesn't have enough.
Kaiser getting caught off right at the start. It comes down to the decisiveness once more, where G2 go in a straight line at one target, and Mad Lions themselves have to be split up in this fight. So you can see the value of the Cho'Gath right here. Forces Shadow to dash away. The slow field's on the ground, makes it so that Humanoid can't get in. Even with the ultimate that hits all five members of G2, they can't go forward. The front line of G2 is simply way too beefy. So Karzi can't actually auto-attack the front line. He's on full runaway duty, and with the Yumi, G2 just will not slow down either. They're going to go straight underneath.
Difficult to play short-range champions into this Cho'Gath.
Oh no, Wonder still has ultimate too. He can just one-shot Shadow, by the way.
Yep, and he just did. Gets himself another. not at all. A lot more of a team game here from the G2 Esports squad.
Multiple lanes, Shadow
pressure. Shadow tried to find an opportunity, but Caps was easily able to escape that one. Chasing the loss, maybe hoped to get the kick onto Caps, sending him to the Mad Lion squad. Now in a 5v4, actually with Baron empowered, this is going to melt. There's simply no way the Mad Lions can stop this push. Look, they're piecing out, they're running away. Humanoid has decided to play PvE. He's pushing the mid lane. He cannot get back here in time. G2, are they going to push for the win?
G2 are absolutely going for the win here. Humanoid did this in the last game too. He just gave up as his team was losing the Nexus. Now he's frantically trying to recall and get back into the base. But G2 will not be stopped. They still have the minions here. Wonder going to have his ult soon. He's just going to kill Karzy on the fountain here.
Unbelievable. Rupture on the steps into the Feral Scream. That's another rupture again. Plus the poison and G2 Esports style to finish. It's Mad Lions. They will delay the final push until the Nexus finally goes down. G2 Esports are one win away from facing Fnatic in finals.